In Tsukishima, Japan, there's a man named Mr. Mitani who likes to take his giant African tortoise out for walks. His name is Bonchan, and he's 25 years old. Mr. Mitani's wife bought him when he was smaller than the size of the palm of his hand. They expected him to get big, but not this big. And he started to grow rapidly as soon as he hit 10 years old. Now he weighs 70 kilograms, which is about 155 pounds. Mr. Mitani takes him on long walks down Monjodori, which is a famous shopping street from Monjayaki. And when I say long walks, I mean like these 5-minute walks that usually take about an hour because of his slow pace and because of all the people that want to take pictures with him. Mr. Mitani takes him out on these walks so that way he doesn't feel stressed out being cooped up at home. If you're ever in Tsukishima from 3 to 5 p.m. on a very nice day, you'll definitely see Bonchan taking a walk. Maybe even longer because he might refuse to go home. When you're in Japan and you're in for those long hauls on the bullet train, they have the best station food that you need to get for your trip. I'm going to show you three things that I got. I got this aesthetic $12 bento box, and inside it already has chopsticks and a wet towel, and inside it has crab, rice, and meat. What I love about this is that with a tug of a string, it makes your meal heat up. Like you could really see the smoke come out of it. It's amazing. Most bentos do come cold though, so you gotta be on the hunt for the one with the string. Then I got this other bento and it had Fuji-san on it, and I thought it was so pretty, but when I opened it, I didn't realize it was gonna be in the shape of it too. This was about $10. And if you wanna get real fancy, we got this luxurious marbled lean Matsusaka beef sandwich. This one was about $12 and it melts in your mouth. Train station food in Japan is supreme. Cool things you can find at a rest stop in Japan. This one had a peaceful koi pond where children could feed the fish. This one had go-karts. You can ride them if you're 60 kilograms and under. The bathrooms at a Japanese rest stop are always nice. This one has a map to tell you which bathrooms are occupied and unoccupied. It even tells you which one has the Western toilets and the Japanese toilets. The bathrooms here are always so clean. It has a bidet and it plays music if you want privacy. They have bathrooms for children that are accommodating for their size as well. This rest stop has a laundromat, and right next to it has a spa. You can have a quick soak and take a shower for those long drives ahead. And their food courts are always so bomb. They're usually full set meals that you can order from these vending machines. I got this local beef plate. Comes with rice, vegetables, and some miso soup. I got this hot bowl of ramen with fried chicken and rice. That was so good. And while we're headed back on the road, I grabbed a drink from this vending machine. Makes a fresh cup of tea or coffee. And it even has a camera inside to show you how it's being made. Typically from these machines, you can get a plastic topping that goes on top of your lid so that way it doesn't spill while you're on the road. Where I'm from, the rest stops are not as nice as Japan's. I found Milkape in Tokyo. I remember him going viral as a Twitter meme last year. When I Googled him, it said, "Milkape is considered to be the king of Jungle Thick. He is made of chocolate and is being held captive in a pot of milk." I don't know who started it or where the story came from, but he's literally just chocolate that's meant to be enjoyed. So I went ahead and made him into hot chocolate. It's not like he's real or anything, right?